Unto thee, O Lord, will I lift up my soul. My God, I have put my trust in thee. O let me not be confounded. Neither let mine enemies triumph over me. For all they that hope in thee shall not be ashamed. Show me thy ways, O Lord, and teach me thy paths. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Unto thee, O Lord, will I lift up my soul. My God, I have put my trust in thee. O let me not be confounded, neither let mine enemies triumph over me. For all they that hope in thee shall not be ashamed. Show me thy ways, O Lord, and teach me thy commandments. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith: Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it: Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God,
give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life, in which thy Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal. Through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray, we beseech thee, O Lord, mercifully, to hear the prayers of thy people, that, being delivered from all adversities and all false doctrines, thy church may serve thee in freedom and quietness, through the same Jesus Christ, our Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray, O Almighty God, who has committed to the hands of men the ministry of reconciliation, we humbly beseech thee that by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, to put it into the hearts of many to offer themselves for this ministry, that thereby mankind may be drawn to thy blessed kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The epistle was written in the 13th chapter of the epistle of Paul to the Romans, beginning at the 8th verse. Owe no man anything but to love one another. For he that loveth another hath fulfilled the law. For this: Thou shalt not commit adultery, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not covet. And if there be, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness, thou shalt not covet. And if there be any other commandment, it is briefly comprehended in this saying, namely, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Love worketh no ill to his neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. And that, knowing the time, that now it is not high time to awake out of sleep, for now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envy. Put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lusts thereof. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel is written in the 21st chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the first verse. At that time, when they drew near unto Jerusalem and were come to Bethphage under the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, Go into the village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied and a colt with her. Loose them, and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, The Lord hath need of them, and straightway he will send them. All this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying, Tell ye the daughter of Zion, Behold, thy king cometh unto thee, meek and sitting upon an ass, and a colt the foal of an ass. And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, and brought the ass and the colt, and put on them their clothes, and they set them thereon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strawed them in the way. And the multitude that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna in the Son of David! Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. And when he was come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, Who is this? And the multitude said, This is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee. And Jesus went into the temple of God, and cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers and the seats of them that sold doves, and said unto them, It is written, My house shall be called the house of prayer, but ye have made it a den of thieves. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church, I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As I mentioned in the announcements, this Advent is a twofold coming of our Lord, and we remember and recall and prepare for both of those things. First is the wrapped in swaddling clothes in a manger in Bethlehem, and the second is his coming again with great power and glory as King, Lord, and Judge of us all. Now today in the readings we have a twofold thing to ruminate on. First of all is love. Isn't that good? It's very powerful and basic, isn't it? And then the second thing is preparation that you and I need to do before we meet our Maker face to face. Let's talk about love first. Now that's from the epistle. And I want to tell you a story about an individual who came to me years ago, and she told me that one of those doctors that she knew and she actually worked for was having an affair with one of his nurses. And she told me the whole sordid story. And so I listened, and she completed the story, and I said, "That's really sad." And she said, "But they love one another." As if to justify his inclination to suspend his marriage commitment, he was married, ignore his children, he had several of them, and he cared not one whit about anyone other than himself. All in the name of love, I guess, huh? When we love one another, and we hear that in the epistle today, don't we? Perhaps we may be tempted to indulge in tomfoolery. That's the human condition. But remember, temptation means to be tested. Okay? And when you do things unloving to others, you have failed the test. That's just pure and simple the proclamation of the epistle this day. We hear, "Owe no man anything but to love one another." And then we hear, "Don't commit adultery, kill, steal, bear false witness, or covet." And if there's any other commandment, it's this: love your neighbor as yourself. Love. Real love. Love works no ill to others. And therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. That's what the epistle tells us. Alas, alack, we have a problem with love, don't we? We kind of play at it, and we really don't want to get into it because it's cost too much, huh? But so we say things and we live our life by saying, "I love hot dogs, I love beer, I love football," etc., etc., ad nauseum. And we have a problem, and that is the fact that we only have one word for love, and that's love. The Greeks were a lot smarter than we are in our day and age. They had four, essentially, words for love, and they were all a bit different. Storge, philia, eros, and agape. Okay, storge is the love that you and I were born into. It's family love. It's a unique kind of commitment one to another. It's family love, storge. Philia is when we grow up a little bit and we can actually choose who we want to be friends with. Philia is brotherly love, okay? The city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. Eros, it's a beautiful one. It's erotic love, love between a man and a woman. Let me say that again. Love between a man and a woman, that's erotic love. And most generally, or oftentimes anyway, procreation is involved with it because of the love that the two people have. But then there's agape. You know what that is? That's what we hear about in the New Testament all the time. The love of God for man and the love of man for God. That agape is unconditional love that transcends and persists regardless of circumstance. God loves you and me even when we are doing the stupidest things that we can imagine. That's agape love. It transcends and persists regardless of circumstance. And so the question is, I think, don't we want the best love that we can have in life? It's agape. Let me give you an example. If you could, and it's not any financial considerations or anything else, but if you could have the car that you would want to buy, would you choose a Trabant? You know what that is? Other side of the big curtain, you know? Or how about a Corvair? Or maybe an AMC Gremlin? Wouldn't that be good? Or would you choose an Aston Martin? Which one would you choose? That's what it's all about regarding love. Choice. We can have any sort of love and any sort of car that we want to. It doesn't mean that we're smart in our choices, however, and oftentimes we're not. And the truth of the matter is that our actions tell others who we are inside and out when dealing with matters of morality and godliness. Now, I don't think anybody would argue the fact that love is what motors us, gives us juice enough to get up and live life. But we can drive right off the cliff because of our stupid choices, can't we? And so what do? Well, we stop and we look and we listen. And then we ask God for help. He will. And He has. So that's love, the epistle. Now the gospel. This is an interesting thing. It's all about preparation. You might think at first blush that it was a mistake that we heard the entry into Jerusalem, and that he goes into the temple and cleanses the temple and throwing out the riffraff. And he said, "My house shall be called the house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves." That's Palm Sunday stuff, isn't it? What's that about on the first Sunday in Advent? Well, it's a rehearsal of the event, but it also is a symbolic truth that is given to us regarding preparation in our life. Not just a declaration of the particular historic event. You see, once again, Advent, we look forward to the twofold coming of Christ. When he came in great humility, Christmas, incarnation, and when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead. It's not one or the other, it's both. Both will happen. So what to do? The collect for Advent tells us, cast aside the works of darkness, adultery, killing, stealing, bearing false witness, coveting, and all the other stupid things we do one to another, not thinking about what our actions are. Cast aside the works of darkness and put upon us the armor of light, that is Christ. Love, then, as best you can. And then we will all be ready to greet him in this life and the next. All things come of thee, O Lord. Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Pray for all those who have died, especially the past President of the United States, George Herbert Walker Bush. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who to confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who are in this transitory life in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially George, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
very meek, right and our bounded in duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we lord and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for the thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify, with thy word and Holy Spirit, these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And We earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray now as our Savior Christ hath taught us. We are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come. And at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we, being opened by the succor of thy mercy, may be both free from sin and safe from all disquietness. All this we beg in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Come, Holy Ghost, our souls inspire. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our souls may be washed clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Amen.
Amen. I receive the bread of heaven, and I call upon the name of the Lord, and it's my strength and my salvation. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Eat and drink this in the remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee, and be thankful. Amen. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
Lord be with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Grant to us, O Lord, we beseech thee, so to wait for thy loving kindness in the midst of thy temple, that in reading readiness of heart and mind, we may hail the coming feast of our redemption. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.